Greetings, my name is Monty Martin and welcome back to Isadora 101. In this series of video tutorials, I'm going to be introducing you to the core features and functionality of Isadora 3. Now, today we are going to take what we have learned across several previous tutorials, including our tutorials on using movie players and projector actors in the picture player actor, as well as using video effects actors and value scaling. So if you're just diving in with us for the very first time, you might want to go back and review a few of those previous tutorials so that you can jump into this again with some fresh eyes. Because the concept that we're going to be looking at today is how to compose or composite video images in Isadora by using multiple projector actors simultaneously and multiple pieces of imagery, blending them all together into one coherent whole to create some really beautiful images. In our previous tutorials, when we were looking at our video effects actors, by and large, we were simply using one media source with several video effects actors layered on top of it. Instead, what we're going to be looking at now is using multiple pieces of media working together to form one coherent image. Now, it's helpful for us to start to understand how Isadora treats multiple projector actors when they are present together at the same time in one scene. Isadora has a layer system, and for those of you that are familiar with graphic design or video editing applications, the concept of layers will be very, very familiar to you. Layering in these applications is similar to making a collage. We are taking a stack of images, perhaps cutting them into different shapes, pasting them onto our canvas, and stacking them on top of each other in layers. This means that the image that is on the topmost layer is in the foreground and is wholly visible, whereas the images that are on the lower layers may be partially obscured in some way, shape, or form by the images in front of them. This is the essence of compositing. We can rearrange the images within our layers and change the order of the layers as well to create a visual collage of multiple media pieces that all combine to create one stunning image. Now, let's take a moment to observe just what happens in Isadora when we have two pieces of media running discreetly at the same time. I've got a scene right here, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take two images and bring them into my scene. I think I'll grab this Nature Sunset Ultra JPEG, drop it in, lovely image there, and then I'm going to add this image of the bean, drag it in, and now this is going to create another picture player and a second projector. That is not very pretty. The default behavior when we have multiple projector actors in Isadora is that Isadora adds them together. This is called additive blending. And what this means is that Isadora simply looks at the two images and says, all right, well, I'm just going to mix these pictures together. Similar to like as if we'd mixed paint. Obviously, it's not blurry or anything like that, but the bright spots of the image tend to get brighter and the dark spots of the image tend to get filled in with the other image. These two images aren't stacked on top of each other. They're actually occupying that same virtual layer together. And what we can do even within this is we can alter the zoom on our projector actors, as well as the width, height, vertical position, and horizontal position, simply to rearrange these elements within our stage. Let's take a look. If I change their zoom down to, say, maybe 33%, making them a third of the size. I'm going to do this with both my projector actors, and then now I'm simply going to move the horizontal position on them. I only need to move one, and you can see that now I've got these two images side by side, and they look just fine. And if I were to, say, add another image into the mix and do the same thing, maybe put its horizontal position the other way around, I'm actually doing compositing right here. Simply by changing the zoom of my individual projector actors and altering their horizontal and vertical position, I could reposition these images and make a little bit of a still collage. You'll notice that when an image doesn't fill the entire canvas, Isadora defaults to black in the background, and this is pretty useful for us, particularly if we're working in a performance environment, because we're just going to send video black out there. So we could simply work like this, bringing in even video images as well. And again, I can change that zoom, maybe make this one just 25%, and maybe alter its vertical position, and bring in my video of the jellyfish, bring its zoom down again to 25%, and I'll alter its vertical position and its horizontal position. Just move it over a little bit like that. And maybe even this other image of a breakdancer. Get a couple videos here. Again, I'm going to lower the zoom on this one. Just rearrange things a little bit here for a moment. Bring that vertical position up. And bring that horizontal position over a little bit more. Yeah, like so. And maybe then I'll just alter this one's vertical as well. So I've kind of got a pretty basic composition here. None of these images are stacked on top of each other, but I'm showing them all at the same time in sort of a collage sort of, a video collage sort of look. And I'm working with images here that are of different resolutions, of different sizes, of different shapes. And so one of the things that you might find is that maybe you want to adjust their size and shape just a little bit. This can be a tricky decision because maybe you might be better off actually taking it into an image editing application and cropping it there, but you can do some quick and dirty work here as well. We do have a crop actor in Isadora, so I can add that to my scene, and I can just use this like any other video effects actor. I can drop that right in here, and I'm just going to slot something into the foreground. You'll notice the crop actor has two video inputs. I'm just going to use the topmost one for this purpose right now. And then I can just crop out some of the left and right. Maybe if I take out the right sides here and the left side by 20%. Yeah, just cut that image down a little bit. By simply using the crop actor and the horizontal, vertical position and the zoom on your various actors, you can do a lot here just with this alone. This element on its own gives us lots of freedom and flexibility to juxtapose multiple media elements side by side. But once again, if I move one of these images in such a way that it overlaps with another one, I'm going to get this blended look between those two images. Now, you might like that, and there might be certain media images that you're working with where this is very, very effective and it looks pretty cool. But we can do a little bit better than this and start exploring other ways to use our images and stack them on top of each other. Let's take a look at how we might do that. So I have six projector actors in my scene, and one thing is in common between all of them. Every single one of these actors has its blend mode set to additive. That is what is telling Isadora, hey, if you have two projector actors right now, I want you to just blend those images together. I just want you to add them when you blend them. But we can change the blend mode on our projector actors. I recommend that you have all the projector actors in your scene operating on the same blend mode. You can make some decisions within that, but it is best that you keep everything consistent across one scene when you're starting out with this. Once you are ready to experiment a little bit further and see what some of the interesting results are, you might want to try some different things. But for now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to all of these guys and I'm going to click them and I'm going to switch every single one of them to transparent blend mode. Okay. And that'll just take me a moment to do that. There's only three modes: transparent, additive, and opaque. So once they're all set to transparent, you'll notice immediately that my image of the jellyfish and my image of the breakdancer, those two images now are no longer being blended together in that additive sense, but the jellyfish are actually on top of the breakdancer. This is because all my images are now set to transparent, but all of my images are also on the same layer. We can tell Isadora manually which layer it is to render its image for each individual projector. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go onto all of my projector actors and I'm going to give them all a different layer, and we'll see what the results of this are going to be in a moment. I'm going to make one of these guys. We'll do the jellyfish because it is the most recent one here. We will put it on layer 6. We will put the people walking in the street on layer 5, the breakdancer on layer 3, and then 3, and then layer 4, layer 2, and layer 1. Whichever projector actor in your scene has the highest value on the layer number amongst the projector actors that are all set to transparent blend mode will be the image that appears on top. So now, if I go to all my projectors and I reset their horizontal and vertical positions back to 0 on every single one, the jellyfish is on top. Okay? And if I now go into each of these images, starting with the jellyfish, and I'm going to just move their horizontal positions here, just off to the side, and just off to the side, and just off to the side, and we'll leave that one in the center there, and we'll bring this one back just the other way, and this one back the other way. So I've now got almost all of my images visible in some way, shape, or form because I've pulled them all apart by modifying their horizontal positions. But they're still stacked on top of each other, again, like a collage. So you have a lot of power and flexibility when you are working in this way. We can now place our images. We don't need to place our images in this same sort of haphazard way. We can go a little bit more flexible and a little bit more creative, adjusting their vertical positions. So I've pulled all these images out from each other and created a more interesting collage of all of my various images. One thing to watch out for when we are doing this is I now have 6 projector actors in my scene. I have 3 movie players. I have 3 picture players. It can be very tempting once you start doing this to want to combine a lot of assets together, but always be mindful of the performance of your machine. If you are playing a lot of high definition movie files, if you are playing a lot of high resolution images and using multiples of these, more than even 8, 10, 20, depending on your computer, it can vary a little bit. I'm working on a 15-inch MacBook Pro, and I can quite comfortably play 10 high-definition movies at the same time in one scene on my machine. But depending on the type of computer that you're using, you might need to test a little bit just to see how many limits you can push on your machine. Isadora is powerful, but it is limited by what your computer hardware is for how many things you can play at the same time. This is a very powerful technique for when you are compositing images. And I hope that you will find these techniques useful in some way when you compose beautiful images that combine multiple video streams, whether they are pre-recorded, still images, or live. That's all for this tutorial. We will see you at our next workshop.